Let's talk fertilizer. It's been a while since we've made a fertilizer video, so I am going to compare my favorite inorganic fertilizer mix with this fertilizer for Julia. How do we figure out which one's better? We look at the label, silly. I know people of all levels watch my video, so this is going to be a two-part series. The first part will be for beginners, really everyone, and then the second part will be a deep dive into part one. Let's go! I had not heard of Purived until Julia tagged me on the video, so of course I had to look for the guaranteed analysis and the ingredients, and I could not find it anywhere on their website. I actually had trouble finding it online. It wasn't until I came across this Amazon review that I was able to find it. Thank you to Four Tokens for taking multiple pictures of the bottles, so I was actually able to review this. Before hopping onto the labels, let's look at the cost of each of these. For 32 ounces of Dyna-Gro Foliage Pro, it is $22.68. For maintenance care, you use half a teaspoon per gallon, and that comes out to be 192 gallons. Ah! For 20 ounces of Purived, that comes out to be $24.99. And you use 2 teaspoons per gallon, which comes out to be 60 gallons per bottle. Boo! Wait. So far, that only means you have to buy Purived more frequently. That's it. We still don't know which one's better, so let's look at the bottles. Let's start with guaranteed analysis. So this is straight from the Purived bottle, and I do want to point out there is 2 manganese listed here. I think this must be an error of some kind with the guaranteed analysis being 2 different numbers. I am a little concerned about that. Purived does have all the macro and micronutrients in here that you might need. The only thing would be maybe silica or cobalt, and that's about it. Next, we have Dyna-Gro's guaranteed analysis, which shows a breakdown of some of the nutrients like nitrogen and magnesium. Now, let's put them both up here. The first are always going to be the macronutrients, which is NPK. You will always see the numbers for this on the front of fertilizers. It's usually like a number dash number. Everything below those 3 are micronutrients, which your plant also needs. It's not as important. That's why it's micronutrients. Just like we need iron and calcium, so do plants. If we look at the 2 side by side, they have all the same nutrients except each has 1 critical element, the other does not. Do you see it? Purived has boron and Dyna-Gro has cobalt. Neither of them have silica, which is important to your plants. I don't think it's actually a nutrient or listed as a nutrient, but it is very important to your plants. Looking at these side by side, Dyna-Gro has more in everything except phosphate, molybdenum, I can't say that word, we're going to call it moly, and zinc. But does that mean it's better? No, not necessarily. Purived is a well-balanced fertilizer, while Dyna-Gro Foliage Pro is for foliage. For normal houseplants, either would be great. I do think you'll get more bang for your buck with Dyna-Gro. However, either of these are great fertilizers. They're both better than a lot of other products on the market. But are they better than organic fertilizers? No. Absolutely not. I do want to point out, while looking for these photos, I noticed that Dyna-Gro now has Super Thrive on the label. This personally concerns me a little bit, as I don't really like or trust Super Thrive. It's kind of like snake wheels. Hopefully it's just a consolidation of the brands and they're not going to change the Dyna-Gro formula. I haven't noticed a change yet. My old bottle is still the same as the bottle that is online as far as ingredients and everything. But that is something I think we all need to be aware of. If you're interested in doing a deep dive into the ingredients or learning what cobalt and boron do, stick around for part 2. This is for more immediate and expert growers. Let's bring up the total analysis for Purived again. in Purived, we have boron, which is not in Dyna-Gro. You may have heard boron before, not involving plants, and that is because it is borax. Yes, you heard me right. Borax, the same stuff you use to clean and put in your laundry. And for your plants, it helps to uptake sugars, it helps with cell division, it helps with fruit and flowers, it helps with a lot of things. It's a micronutrient, and the only plants that I really know that are heavy feeders are fruits and vegetables. So like apples, grapes, cabbage, broccoli. So does that mean you should give it to your houseplants? Absolutely. Does that mean I think you should go out right now and get boron to feed to your houseplants if it's not in the fertilizer you've been using? No. Now, if you're using a soilless media and have been using the same fertilizer for years without boron, you may want to get something with boron in it. Or you can just add borax to it, but make sure there's nothing else in it. Do your research, because this is a critical micronutrient. Now let's switch to the Dyna-Gro total analysis. This has cobalt in it, which Purived does not. And cobalt has pretty recently been listed as a micronutrient. Some studies say it's not really important to a lot of plants. Others say you should be using it in all of your plants. So we are going to be using it in all of our plants. Legumes are heavy cobalt feeders. So if you're growing any type of beans, definitely want to have a fertilizer heavy in cobalt. And cobalt is needed to help your plants survive, especially if you're an underwaterer, as it helps with drought resistance. It helps with leaves getting larger, stem growth. It helps to convert and uptake nutrients. And it's even said to help plants form bonds with beneficial bacteria. How cool is that? I've mentioned before that plants can't uptake vitamin B, but cobalt does help plants create vitamin B on their own. If you use kelp in your plants already, chances are you are giving them a significant supply of cobalt. Let's move on to the ingredients of these two. The first two ingredients on this list are different, but also kind of the same. They're both nitrogen, but in different forms. In Purived, it's urea, and in Dyna-Gro, it's ammonium nitrate. In Dyna-Gro, there are other ingredients that provide nitrogen, but we're not going to talk about that right now. Now, don't go looking too deep into ammonium nitrate, because that's what explosives are made of. And you don't want to be put on some type of list with our governments. For plants, it provides immediate nitrogen availability, so you'll see results pretty quickly. Urea requires beneficial bacteria to break it down before the plants can uptake it, so it's a little bit of a slower process, but not super slow. Overall, they are both very common and great inorganic fertilizer options for nitrogen. If I remember correctly, it's nitrate nitrogen, then urea nitrogen, and then ammonia. I can never say that word. Hold on. And then
ammoniacal
nitrogen would be the slowest. I could have ammoniacal and urea mixed up, but I'm pretty sure that ammoniacal nitrogen is the slowest to be converted for plants. Looking at the next items on these lists, Purived uses a purer form of each ingredient. Phosphoric acid is phosphorus and can be quickly absorbed by the plants. Next is the potassium hydroxide. This is where the potassium comes from. Then we have boric acid, which we've already discussed. That's boron. And then all these ingredients with the letters EDTA after them, if we look at Dyna-Gro, it also has EDTA on it. EDTA means... I'm not going to try to say this word, okay?
Ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid.
Ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. EDTA is a chelate, and it's the most common chelating agent out there. I could literally make a whole entire video on chelates and minerals and how they work. Let me know if you guys want that. We're not doing that here, though. Layman terms, without a chelate, a plant wouldn't be able to absorb metals like copper or calcium or iron. Let's move on to Dyna-Gro. The second ingredient listed is calcium nitrate, which is just calcium and nitrogen. Since we were just talking about chelates, the calcium here can be absorbed because it's not in its pure form. It's not just calcium, it's calcium nitrate. And calcium nitrate is water soluble, so it can be absorbed by the plants. Next on the list is potassium nitrate, which is just potassium and nitrogen. Then we have monoammonium phosphate, and that's just nitrogen and phosphorus. We have monopotassium phosphate, which is just potassium and phosphorus. Then we have cobalt sulfate. The next ingredient is magnesium sulfate, which is commonly known as Epsom salt. Oh, and sulfur, I forgot to mention sulfur, which was in the last two ingredients. So sulfur also helps plants as well. Next we have molybdic oxide, which is where molybdenum comes from. I cannot say that word. I need some practice. And moly is actually very similar to cobalt, actually, when it comes to plants. Well, it is, but it also isn't. Okay, hear me out. They're both really important to legumes, and they both help with nitrogen conversion, although cobalt happens with beneficial bacteria, and with moly, the conversion happens within the plant. And last on DynaGro, we have all the metals that end with EDTA, which we've already discussed with Purived. Both of these fertilizers are great fertilizers. If you picked either of them, you picked a great choice. But with this breakdown, I do think DynaGro is a little better just because of the price. You would go through three entire bottles of Purived before going through a single bottle of DynaGro. While they both have different ingredients, the outcomes are very similar. Anyways, I hope I was able to teach you something. Let me know in the comments if there's anything you want me to break down or discuss further. Make sure to hit that plus sign, and don't forget to be like your plants and continue to grow. Bye, see you next time.